separate your head from your shoulders.
Do it fast.
All right.
The time's wrong. No!
You might as well just kill me then, too.
Caleb Colton no longer belongs to our world.
We give him a week to see if we can call him one of us.
He belongs to hers.
But you have to learn to kill.
He belongs to theirs.
I don't want to kill.
He makes a kill tonight.
And they all belong to the night.
It's $3 short for a bus ticket home. You help me out?
What are you on?
Believe me, I told you.
Just don't think of it as killing.
Evening.
Woo! Don't think at all. It's just something that you do night after night. It's only ever a question of how.
Nervous. I would be too if I were you.
Near dark.
It'll be your boys falling in with control.
Check out time.
Bought yourself some time, son.
God damn, this is my family, let it go!
Near dark. Pray for daylight. The night has its price.
Welcome to Movie Humpers.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
It's Halloween.
Ooh.
It's Halloween time.
It is Halloween time.
And we explored some sexual themes this week.
Yes.
Where this is very timely. We didn't record this way ahead of time.
No way.
To compensate for the fact that every day in the weekday in October, we're doing a draw. Very timely. Just think about all the Halloween movies we watched this first week. Let's just stop and reflect. It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Great. That... Christopher Lee, Dracula, great.
So good.
Revisiting that It Follows movie, great. Fantastic. Rabid, what a fun.
I mean, yeah.
Not perfect, but fun.
So much fun.
And yeah, I can't remember what the other one is. So, it's Halloween.
Who are you?
I'm Bob Sham.
I'm Angela.
The sounds you may hear are dogs. And we are discussing today.
Snoring right now.
A bit of a cult vampire hit back in 1987, directed by Kathryn Bigelow, who would, I think her next movie after this was Point Break. She directed
Point Break. Which I don't remember. I would love to rewatch that at some point.
And she also directed our modern military propaganda movies like The Hurt Locker and Zero Dark Thirty.
When her name started being more well known, I think.
Yeah, Hurt Locker won like Best Picture, I think.
Yeah.
I don't think that was a bad movie.
Or did she get Best Director?
I can't remember.
Okay, I don't know.
I don't think Hurt Locker was a bad movie, but it was, I mean, typical, right? Like, you really think this is the best movie?
It also felt like there was a period of time where every movie was a movie very much like that, like about a mission during wartime.
Yeah.
And it just felt like there was so many of them that honestly can't, like Black Hawk Down is sort of maybe what I think of whenever I think of any of those movies like that.
I think that happened in Somalia.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't even remember what The Hurt Locker was about.
It was about Jeremy Renner being a bomb-defusing maverick.
Oh.
And it was, I felt like it was a little over the top, like kind of goofy in how characters were in that movie.
Yeah, maybe I've just never seen that. Well, I was told that some people, and I did not verify this, but some people prefer this movie to Lost Boys. I had never seen this film. I love Lost Boys.
Yeah,
that was my first vampire love.
Well, this movie kind of flopped when it came out in 87, but it does have a cult appreciation. I think it's stylistically kind of a nice movie. There's really good shots in it. This is also more of an iconic role for Bill Paxton. He's kind of the most memorable from this movie. When you look at posters of the movie and images, it's always like him with his half burnt up face in it.
Yeah, well, because he's like the crazy sexy one.
He's like over the
leader's like an old man.
Lance Henriksen plays him, and this also stars Adrian Pasdar, which I don't know if you remember that show Heroes.
Yeah.
Remember the president, the guy that flew?
Oh, that was...
That was Adrian Pasdar. Yeah.
I would have never.
And then Jenny Wright, who is the hottie of the movie.
And it's called Near Dark.
Near Dark. Neo-noir western. Because it's not like throwback John Ford western. But like...
Sure.
The neo terms, I would like to be done with them.
Yeah.
Truly.
Every time you say it, I'm like...
Neo-noir, neo-western, I get it. But noir is noir, right? It is just kind of weird. But this movie, I do think there is a style to this movie. And this also has a score by Tangerine Dream, who did the Thief score. But I'll be honest, I was real up and down on the song. The more synthy ones I like.
Yeah.
But outside of the setting of where they're at, nothing really felt like the West to me, right?
I agree.
Like, no, it didn't really hit that vibe except for... The environment was pretty well captured. Kathryn Bigelow really did, and Adam Greenberg, the cinematographer, really did capture that.
Yes.
And I think, I'll have to rewatch The Lost Boys. It's been a long time. Didn't the Lost Boys have the concept of you kill the head vampire and the other vampires die?
Yeah.
That's a little bit simple. A little bit simple. But I would give Lost Boys the advantage because...
I think it had that because you had to kill the big bad.
Yeah, who ended up being the dad, right?
Well, the guy mom was dating.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lost Boys does have the advantage because Lost Boys had that song that goes like, cry, little sister, we shall not fall. Come to your brother. Right?
Yep.
That's by G. Tom Mack.
It's good.
I don't think he had any other hit.
Listen, it's good.
I throw that song on every Halloween playlist.
Lost Boys, I don't know. We're not here to talk about the Lost Boys. But
that's true.
Near Dark.
It's kind of hard not to compare the two. 80s vamp fair. You know?
Well, truly. And one thing that they also have in common, which we don't see that often, obviously, Interview the Vampire is pretty famous for it, is child vampires. So there is a kid who's a vampire in Lost Boys. There's a kid who's a vampire in this. The kid who's the vampire in this, I only know from one other film, and that is Teen Witch. And I apologize for all the times you've heard my brother and I quote him in Teen Witch, but he's the one that says the classic line,
nobody wants to date you because you're a dog. A dog! A dog!
But we say that.
That kid's not much different.
You're a dog.
In that he's just a vampire in this movie.
He's just who he is.
And he's supposed to be very old.
Yeah, he's who he is. He's supposed to be very old. Doesn't come across. Doesn't work.
Let's breeze through this. This Oklahoma boy, Adrian Pasdar, he sees a hot vampire girl.
I see the president in Heroes now. Okay, I'm there. I got it.
And he flew. That was his power. He meets this girl and... We get quickly that she's probably like a creature of the night, right? But they kind of link up fast. Like they move very quickly.
Well, he hits on her.
Yeah. Not literally all. He didn't like literally hit her.
No, but she's eating an ice cream.
Yeah.
And he like goes to talk to her and like his friends want to talk to her too. And he truly like pushes them off and is like, no, she's mine.
Wouldn't she throw up eating that ice cream?
She was just like, I don't think she was really eating it.
Okay.
I think she was just like.
Oh, baiting.
Baiting.
So, yeah.
It's sexy, right? She's licking the ice cream.
So, they end up connecting real quick. And she bites him and runs the fuck away.
Because she likes him.
Yeah. And so, he's like, I like you.
And she doesn't want to bite him. Because she's trying to get him to drive her home before the sunrise. And he stops the car and he's like, you got to kiss me.
Oh, right. He's like fucking with her.
And if he hadn't done that, but then they start kissing and she's overcome and she bit him.
Yeah.
She's attracted to him and she's hungry.
Mm-hmm.
She's going to bite him.
Yeah.
It's kind of his fault.
Yeah. Imagine if like...
I just victim blamed
anytime
the guy who became a vampire.
It's okay. Anytime like a squirrel bit you, you got like squirrel abilities.
Mm.
I don't know why I went there. But anyway.
You like baiting squirrels?
So he's running home. He's running home and he's starting to... the sun is starting to smoke him.
He's smoking.
And his skin is turning dark. And apparently when they, if they can get out of the sunlight,
they can heal.
They can heal pretty quickly. As he's approaching, he sees his dad and sister.
Yeah.
He's right by his house. And then this RV comes up and like snatches him and then takes off. Mm-hmm. And the dad, look, I like horror. I think horror is a lot of fun. I won't say that I'm like a big horror head like a lot of people are. But horror is the genre where I'm most often going, why are you doing that?
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. And dad,
a lot of leaps.
So dad sees his son get kidnapped and yanked into an RV. And instead of running immediately to his truck and telling the daughter to go call the police, he's trying to chase after the RV after it's like going down.
Can I say though?
Yeah.
I feel like that's more realistic because in that moment, you don't know what the fuck is going on. And so if you're immediately like, call 911, throw me my keys, get in the truck. Like, do you know how to do that?
You know what? I'll give him the dad the benefit of the doubt there. Though.
You're just like freaking out. And then like you can't catch them. So you realize I need to get in the truck.
So there he's in this RV. He never goes, hey, what's going on here? What am I? Who are you? But it's
at
just,
some point, he, I think, says to her.
It's just understood
everybody that, vampires,
that they
right?
are essentially vampire. I don't even know if the word vampire is used in this movie.
I don't know if it is.
And they're not showing fangs.
No, we never see fangs.
And I don't really have much of a problem with that.
I need fangs.
We do get finicky about our vampires.
I like fangs. And I actually
it's going to be
like,
a big vampire month, so.
I like this use of the sunlight in this movie.
That is kind of the coolest aspect of the movie.
This is my perfect use of vampire and sunlight. Mm. You will die. If you do not get out of the sun, you will burst into flames. But if you can cover, if you can hide, like if you can get out of the sun and like feed soon enough, you can reheal. And I like that.
It is straight up like if you're not smoking and simmering and starting to burn up in the sunlight, mm-hmm. these vampires that can kind of hang or turn into glitter, Mm-mm. That's the one thing we need from our vampires. They burn up in the sun.
And also what I liked about this was he walked through a whole field smoking, and that makes sense because he just had gotten bit. He was not fully turned yet. If he'd been fully turned, he wouldn't have made it through that field.
That's true. Later, the vampires who are more fully turned, it's like almost fast. Like light, yeah. They catch on fire when their
it's like
hand
getting,
reaches
it's like
the
getting
sunlight.
Shot by a laser when a sunbeam hits them.
So he meets all these vampires, the and like a kid who's like claimed to be very old. A couple, one is Lance Henriksen mm-hmm. and Bill Paxton, who is a over the top lunatic.
Yeah.
So they're hanging around.
And May is the girl.
I think he takes off at one point, and then he has to keep becoming reunited because she can't get far.
He tries to leave, but he's drawn back to her and them because he doesn't know what to do. He tries to eat, and he pukes.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, he can't. He doesn't know what to do. And then he realizes, like, I'm a vampire.
So throughout the movie, they're trying to get him to kill someone.
Mm-hmm.
And
he's got to prove himself, too.
Yeah.
He's feeding off of her, which is dangerous for her, because if he drinks too much, she's going to die.
And there's parts where these vampires are so fucking wild and reckless.
Mm-hmm. I did like that part.
In this world, coast-to-coast episodes, like Art Bell, he would be talking like, there's like people are getting their blood drained in Oklahoma.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
That's all Coast to Coast would be talking about in this world. Like, there's so much evidence left behind that there's something fucking crazy going on
in
the Midwest.
But they also are not exclusively biting people, and they're also just killing for fun. So they're not even necessarily feeding that much off of each person. It seemed like it just looked like a fucking massacre when they were in that one bar and they like killed everybody in the bar.
I mean, you got spree killers essentially. Mm-hmm. Like, there should be even like a shitty cop
would be able to
kind of put like two and two together here. They go into that honky tonk,
mm-hmm.
and let me tell
That's
you,
what I'm talking about. And let they me massacre.
And let me tell you, very sad that these good old boys. What, like only the bartender was strapped? The rest of these, everyone's
just
standing there.
Oh, yeah, you straight up were there. Like, where are the guns?
It's like, bro, where, my red staters, where y'all need to back up your, you need to back it up, right?
Yeah.
Let's be honest. If you were truly tested and a vampire was in front of you, most people, no matter how badass they thought they were, would probably be like, oh, shit. So maybe it's realistic in that sense.
Yeah.
But, like, only one dude in this fucking good old boy bar is strapped down?
I know.
Bro.
Not even knives.
Yeah. That's kind of like the weird aspect of it that seems mm-hmm. kind of... It captures the environment of the West, but not these weird cultural intricacies. And also, these vampires are like... I don't understand how these vampires made it this long. Because I feel like we're seeing these vampires basically in a suicide run. Like, maybe they're just done at this point, and they're like, fuck it, let's just, like, wreck ass all over the place.
I've also never seen vampires this dirty and gross. Mm. And it actually makes so much sense. It's like when we were talking about crimes of the future and nobody could get infections anymore. And so they just didn't bathe and they were just like dirty and gross and everything was like shit and grimy. That's how these vampires are. Like, they can't get sick. Like, who cares what they smell like? They can probably glamour you to get close to you. Like, they were just, like, dirty and gross the whole time. Like, they come from that fight or whatever. They burn up at one point. They don't even, like, wash themselves off when they're healing. But they got, like, soot all over them because they, like, have a fight. It's crazy. And then also I wanted to mention, because I think this is important, for the end, that little boy vampire, who apparently is an old man.
Yeah.
He turned May, who is the girl that turned our main boy. And so... He hates this dude because he likes May. I think his dream was that they would be together, but honey, a little boy.
Police do corner them in like some like hotel or I forget where they were, but the police do come after them and they're wrecking the place and sunlight's getting in. And the main character decides to, he's making like he's going to escape.
Right,
and then he crashes the RV into the building to where they can enter it. Mm-hmm. He ends up rescuing them. So even though he hasn't killed someone, he's earned their trust. Mm-hmm. And that's when they go to the hotel room later.
I was remembering them in the wrong order.
It was almost a goofy ass scene where one by one, they're like, Bill Paxton's like, here, you can have one of my spurs.
Oh, that's right.
And the kid's like, oh, thanks, man. So
but he does the thing where he's like, goes to shake his hand. He goes,
Yeah.
Just kidding.
It was just so kind of a little bit of a tacky scene.
Yeah.
And so he's accepted by them. And then sure enough, the little old man, the little kid vampire, he goes around to a vending machine. And what does he see there?
He sees our dude's little sister.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Cry, little sister. We shall not fall. Come to your brother.
And he decides that, and you know, somehow, okay, you threw me off. Somehow, in the searching, the father ended up at the same hotel that they were at because he's been looking for his son. So he's dragging his daughter all around the country looking for his son. And so they've somehow ended up in the same motel. And the little girl, this is so funny, like the boy walks up to her and he's like, what are you doing out here all by yourself? And she's like, I do what I want when I want to do it. And it's like, why you got this attitude? And he's this is the most problematic. This is the most problematic thing for me.
Oh, okay.
In this movie.
Okay.
I hate this part of this movie.
Mm-hmm.
Because on one hand, it seems like it would be okay, but it's not. So he
I'm curious here.
He is essentially like, what would you say? He's in the body of like a 13-year-old, 12 or 13-year-old.
Yeah.
She's like 9.
Yeah.
Okay. He decides that he's going to turn this little girl to, like, be his bride, basically. Like, he's going to turn her. He, like, is like, come back to my room.
And watch TV.
And he, like, watch TV. And he's all like, but here's the thing about him.
But okay. He doesn't turn her.
No, he doesn't get to. But he's going to. But he's, like, I think trying to, like, see how she is and, like, see the family. Because you'll notice I wonder if he's tried this before. Because he brought her into the hotel room. And he's, like, trying to turn on the TV. And he's like, this is my friend. And literally immediately the other vampires knew what was up. Now, boy is gone for a minute. He's like out hanging out with May.
Yeah.
So they're gone from the room. So it's just the other three, the old man, his girlfriend, and Bill Paxton. And immediately she goes, honey, what room are you staying in? And she tells her. And then she's like, go get him.
Mm-hmm.
Or who you here with, my daddy. What room are you in? So she's like, go ahead. And so Bill Paxton brings his dad into the hotel room So they all end up in the room at the same time, and it becomes apparent in this huge, like, you're with who and you're who's whatever, that this is his dad and his sister, but these are his vampire new family. And at one point he's even like, I'm with them. But then he realizes that little boy wanted to turn his sister. And now that his dad has seen them and knows their faces, he doesn't know they're vampires, but he knows their faces, they're going to have to kill him.
Yeah.
And so in that moment, he's like, I have to save my family.
Yeah. He just got accepted. Now he has to save his family.
And he even just stood up to his family for them. He's like, let them go. This is who I'm with now. And they're like, we cannot let them go. But the creepy part is that this is a boy who has chosen this little girl that he's going to turn. And the idea was that she would grow up and always be that size. But right now, she's a kid. And mentally, he is not. I don't care what his body is. He's a child predator.
Well, I think that was... I think the feeling you got from that was supposed to be the feeling you got from
disgusting.
That.
But then
I don't think the director was like, I hope they really accept this union of the old vampire and a kid's body and this little girl.
No, but I also feel like with him, it was a blurring of lines. Like, I don't feel like he was not great at acting, or he wasn't direct. He also maybe wasn't directed well.
I mean, he's just a kid in real life, so I don't want to like harp on his acting, but
it wasn't great. He acts like a child.
Yeah.
So it's that whole thing of...
It's like when celebrities...
Is he an immature older man because he looks like a child? But then other times he's like drinking beer and smoking cigarettes and trying to be all cool.
He's like when a celebrity gets famous at like 14 and they grow up and they're essentially stuck at the age they got famous at.
So he's like mentally still like a 12 or 13.
Sure, that makes sense to me. But yeah, it's supposed to be problematic. Like, you're supposed to think that's icky.
I just needed to say it.
Why doesn't he bite her immediately? What is the point of, like, awaiting? There's no leverage here. Wants her.
Yeah.
It's not a bargaining chip.
But just because he wants her doesn't mean she's not going to scream and cry her head off for the next 6 months.
I don't give a fuck. They're crazy.
I think he wants her to like him. Because... I think he did that with May. I think he just was like, I want this girl. And he turned her, and she's like a grown woman who doesn't want to be with him. So this is this little girl, and I think he's immature, but he had thought about it enough that he decided, I need to get her to like me, and then I'll do this, but we'll be friends.
So he manages to escape with his dad and his sister, right?
Yeah, he's like in the back of the truck.
And they go back to, you say they're all over the country, but I don't think they even go further past Texas. Like, they're always in that Midwest kind of desert right before you're going into, they may be,
well, I just mean like maybe New Mexico or something, right? It felt like they were always driving somewhere, but you're right. Yeah, they probably weren't going that far.
It seemed like they were just looping Oklahoma and Texas.
You're just always moving because you're killing people, right? Yeah. So they're just moving as much as you have to not get caught.
Yeah, like this whole thing seems to take place maybe in a span of a week at the most, right? And so main character's dad works in animal husbandry, deals with like blood diseases that they deal with. And so they have this passively throw it out there like, hey, let's do a
blood transfusion.
Because he also has been shot, so he's kind of like all messed up. And so they do a blood transfusion on the main character, and it cures his vampirism. What do you think about the curing vampirism? I don't know.
I don't like it.
Seems a little simple, right?
Yeah,
but
way simple.
Maybe a little too clean, right?
Well, we even thought like maybe it only worked because he was so new of a vampire and he had never fed officially because he never did. But then...
So May shows up.
Yeah.
Because she knows where he lives. Obviously, they're right around the corner. They're in the background. And she's trying to get him to come back, and she realizes like he's warm, like he's different.
Yeah.
And so they're coming for them now. And she kind of warns him and wants him to come back, but it ain't happening.
Yeah.
But so they're coming now. And of course, they could not have timed this worse because it's dawn soon. I forget how it all lays out, but they're like chasing each other in cars and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And their RV is beyond wrecked at this point. They're like,
so there's like beams of light coming through.
They're like in a Oldsmobile. What do you call it? Kind of the hatchbacky, big blocky cars back in the day. You know what I'm talking about. And
like a station wagon?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
And so they're kind of chasing, and the old man character, the kid vampire, he sees the girl and he's so obsessed.
Oh, yeah, the little girl.
Yeah, he's so like drawn and obsessed to her that even though the sun's coming out, he gets out and starts chasing her. He's so like infatuated with her that he walks out into the sun and just is burning. And it, and the, actually the coolest parts of this movie are when they're like in the sun.
Yeah, for when this was made, that fire, the effects are actually pretty good.
Yeah.
And we were watching it. Were we watching on the big, big screen?
Yes.
Yeah, it looked great.
Yeah, it looked great. This kid, we see him burning up. And when they're in the sunlight and they're fully on fire, then they explode in flames. And it was a really actually cool look to see the rest of the vampire. Oh, and Bill Paxton got like wrecked on a semi and like blown up like earlier. Yeah. And he's like, they're really strong. And he's like punching into the engine of a semi. Mm-hmm. And he's like he allows himself to get hit by a semi. And he climbs it and he's like, ha ha ha. Like he's insane. Bill Paxton. Rest in peace, Bill Paxton. Yeah. A fucking lunatic in this movie. But also one of the most memorable parts of it. And they just like explode within the station wagon. And it actually looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
So they put the blanket over the girl, May, and throw her in. And they bring her back. And then they do the blood transfusion on her. And it works.
And she wakes up and she's like scared to death.
Yeah, because she's like,
of course, she has no idea. She's scared
of the sun, of course.
She doesn't know how he became not a vampire. She's still shocked by that, probably. She's just lost her whole family.
Yeah.
And then the sun is shining on her and she's not dying.
Yeah, and now she's human again, just from a blood transfusion. And now they can
get married and have babies.
You know, there is a kind of a deeper psychological implication of the fact that this woman has killed people for who knows how many years. And now she's a human again and has to sit here and reflect on, like, all these people she murdered to sustain herself.
Yeah. Okay. So.
We hump movies.
We hump them.
You're going to give 1 through 5. I'm going to give 1 through 5 combined for best out of 10.
2.5.
So you're hitting pretty much a solid average.
I think so. I mean, I did think it was fun, but it wasn't great. But the effects were good.
Yeah, yeah.
And in talking about it, it is interesting. I don't like that you cannot become a vampire. I mean, you can become not a vampire.
Yeah, yeah.
And I don't like that there's no fangs. But Bill Paxton was good.
Yeah.
And I like the sunlight stuff.
Yeah, there's some good effects for the time. Yeah. I'm going to hit 2.75 because I do think it barely goes over average. I think it is a little memorable. I like the overall style of the movie. Mm-hmm. But there was some kind of like... The tone of the West could have been played up more.
Yeah.
The Tangerine Dream score was a little up and down for me. Like, I felt like it was perfect in Thief. Mm-hmm. Apparently, James Caan hated that score. He didn't understand it.
That's so funny.
And, but yeah, the Tangerine Dream score here is a little more all over the place for me.
Mm-hmm.
And Bill Paxton is cool, but you know, you're just wondering, like, these vampires are just kind of like a little so balls to the wall.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, how are you like one that the lead vampire was like, he's like, I fought for the South. Like that's how he hinted how old he was.
Yeah.
And it's like, how did you make it this long? Like truly be acting like this. Just, you know, they've been spree killing, at least some of them for like well over a century. And like, well, mm-hmm. I guess police did find them that one time, but I'm going to give it 2.75. So that's a 5.25.
Yeah.
And that's definitely a low score for us, but I think there is something fun. Like if you're a casual horror fans would probably get something out of this. I think, and I did kind of enjoy watching it.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if I analyze it, I have to kind of give it that.
That's why for me, I think 5.25 makes sense for this. And listen, that is still, that's a fine movie. It's fine.
Yeah.
To see, right?
It's literally us saying it's fine.
Yeah.
And look at that, folks.
We did it.
Near Dark is our 5th best C tier movie to date. And look. What's so funny?
Feel free to cut this out. I just realized that, like, it's not going to make any sense. Like, there's going to be movies on here and not on here and, like, all kinds of different
because we're bouncing. Because we, We're recording so far
it's
ahead.
It's noticeable if it's like we just record like a few things in the same week out of order.
You're right.
That's usually right next to each other.
You are correct. That is kind of a flaw of our approach here.
October has the potential for multiple C films.
Yes.
I think.
Yeah.
So we might get caught in a little bit of like a...
Folks, if you're tracking the order, and let's be honest, if you're truly tracking that hard,
thank you, and we love you.
I don't know. You might be taking it way too seriously. If you're tracking it that hard,
but
maybe
if you're watching that consistently.
But yeah, we recorded this way out ahead, so we can, you know, we're recording way out. Look, we got plenty of Halloween to go. All right, go to the show notes for links and other places where to find us.
Death to all traitors.
Death to all traitors. Happy Halloween.